We have our Secretary General who gives us the authority, and that is none other than the powerful, the incredible Lewis Ruben Goya. And Ladidwa Wengwengwe, my Secretary General. We are very humble. We have the generals here with our own city. Who humbled himself? Who humbled himself and said, my colleague, go ahead with the flag. I will not fight. That is what NUP is about. You are very powerful. You are a real man. We have our very own from the beginning in the trenches. NUSPA is present. We have one of our candidates all the way from Edinda, Busoga. Wise one who has been around and will be around is a candidate. Where are our other team leaders? Yes, Office Watigulu, sub-regional office, Tiganyi, Lango. Office where we take care of four sub-regions, Lango, Taramoja, West Nile, and Acholi. Office where Tigulu. We have our liaison officer nationally, but in sub-region, Northern, we have the technical person, resilient, quiet, but very solid. Spartan Achilles from Palisa. May I have the honor today to invite our camera person who is always capturing evidence? Cosmas, it is Cosmas, when you see sensational pictures, which many of us miss, that is our person. Our power. I would like to invite our commissioner, electoral commission, the incredible, the courageous, the resilient, the very handsome.
People power.
Our power.
Our power.
People power.
And you be
everywhere.
Everywhere.
People. I would like also to invite, without wasting any more time, the backbone of all the music that suits us. Nubian Lee!
Umbrella is our symbol. Yes, I coordinate the arts and entertainment. Thank you very much, Oyam.
Young artists, may Oyam can please be joking Nubian Lee, because we want those talents to reach out and translate in terms of profession. I would also like to invite and introduce our regional coordinator, that is Samuel Obedigu, the strike machine.
Yes, much respect to Obedigu, strike machine.
Yes,
you
see my leg here,
machine.
It's not how I was born, it came on the third of this month on nomination. But if people like Eddie Montoya, you were not there, by now I would be with my leg up.
Everywhere!
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 are only in Buganda. Today is yet another milestone. For us, we show it by action, by evidence. It is not my day, but I'm very humbled to be on your track, to be part of this rising history. I am humbled. We still continue to get greetings from Atoli Sub-Region. They've not had enough of you, and you are going back to be a good. So without wasting a lot of time, yes, the structures, please, all those who are dealing with the technical, the coordinators and the rest, in the interest of time, we appreciate you. We appreciate you. We structures, we appreciate, we, you are the ones, the, our unsung heroes. Wapoyo, wapoyo, wapoyo. Our default, apoyo. And I'm coming here to make sure we build those structures and we have our training. Wapoyo, myself. Now is the time you get up your notebook. Now is the time you get up your pen. Now is the time you get up what you can use for recording. Because you are going to go through an experience. It is not about talking. This person, our candidate, our legend, will make you to start taking notes. I am humbled to introduce and present our intelligent, courageous, diligent, faithful, very handsome next president of the Republic of Uganda. Father President of National Unity Party Platform,
my brothers and sisters of Oyam, the elders of Oyam, the young people of Oyam, I've been requested to step up on the car. I want to salute you. But most importantly, I want to salute my young brother Adonyo Michael there. You might wonder why I'm saluting a young boy, and pardon me for calling you a young boy, my brother. But the power and the hope that I get from you, you have no idea how much you inspire me. The people of Oyam, I am humbled by the reception that you've given to us. Allow me to salute you and greet you, Kopango! Kopango! Are you my best? We hold this umbrella not because we are trying to cover ourselves from the sun.
Umbrella ni wan pe ma opie not am ni jing pe gowa.
But because this umbrella is the symbol that we are going to use on the ballot paper. But before I even talk about the ballot paper or the umbrella or the election, allow me to tell you that this is history in the making. For the very first time, we have an opportunity to be free men and women in this country. For some of you who are younger than me, there's something you don't know, and something I did not know for a very long time. But I'm sure the elders, 50 years and above, they know exactly what I'm talking about. I have been coming to Northern Uganda just to sing for you and to make money and go back home. But today, I come to you and I come to talk to you because there's something very important that we must know as a generation. 35 years ago, a group of rebels came and captured our country. Those rebels were led by Yoweri Kaguta Museveni. They caused the death of more than 500,000 people. And since that day, we became slaves in our own land. I say we became slaves in our own land. He used two things. First of all, he used violence. He used three things. He used violence. Because it started by killing people. The second thing, he used lies. Because he was promising that there was going to be a fundamental change in Uganda. When he was standing on the footsteps of our parliament, he said the problem of Uganda are the leaders that overstay in power. But 35 years later, he does not want to remember the words that he said. But one very bad thing that he used, that is divide and rule. I say divide and rule. He has divided us according to tribe. He has divided us according to religion. And he has divided us according to political affiliation. But I'm telling you, my brothers and sisters, that today I don't come to you as a politician. Because I've told you before and tell you again that I come to you not as a politician. I don't come to you as a Muganda. I come to you as a son of Uganda. I come to you as your brother. chalo minu, and I come to you as your son. Binuporu jo adawa chala tinu. We are very lucky as a generation. Because our generation is united by the problems and the pain that we go through every day. And yes, we are united by the hope of a new Uganda. In a Uganda where everybody will be equal.
Uganda major Tusha Beda Roma Roma.
I said in a Uganda where everybody will be equal. Where if we want to choose you as a minister, we don't look at your tribe. When we are promoting you in the police, we don't look at your tribe. When you're getting a government job, we don't look at your religion. That is the new Uganda that we are looking at. And that is the message that we bring to you. We know that we don't have so much time, ladies and gentlemen. In the past presidential elections and campaigns, we are given so much time. But because Museveni is very scared of our generation, we are very many young people, and we are very united. That is why
Musoni we mukatono nyo bana abasirikale n'abantu okubatwalira fulaya zibafuukidde ekizibu okubeera nga tebabaganya wadde okubeera nga tebabatwalira fulaya. Yes, kamala okulaba omusirikale ono kyategeeza mu nsonga afande, what is the problem of just the people to give them the what? The flyers. Take the people and go and distribute to them self. Just distribute to them self. Just distribute to them. Give one person a flyer and distribute to themselves. One person, give them one person and distribute to themselves. No, okay, you take them and distribute to themselves. No, what is the problem for people to take the flyers? What is the problem? What is the problem people to take the flyers? Just give the people and distribute to themselves. What is the problem? People to take the flyers. Auntie, what is the problem? People to take the flyers. Auntie, give them and distribute to themselves. What is the problem?
Yeah. Let these people first be there. You will give. No, we are respecting.
Kat, why are you taking them? What is the problem with the flyers? Which law?
I must not give this man's problem. We need to give him the peace of God into the people.
Which peace are you giving them and you are sending them down? What is the peace are you giving to them and you are sending them the other side? Are you in the light position?
Presidential candidates, all that will be moving, we give them that peace, they talk to the people, not others are shouting, others are doing this, they need to get the voice from there. And I'm standing here also getting what he's talking about. Eh? We need to give him time. We need him to talk to the people. The next one will come, we give him a chance. Talk to the people. Eh? Not that someone will be making noise. Some will not be making noise.
You are commanding them. Tell him never to be violent.
Why are you fearing to take pictures? Already you are in your life. Oh, why? Toina chogenda kora gwe. Toina chogenda kora. Nothing you can do. Nothing you can do. Nothing you can do. We're gonna die here in the people of Urila. What are you going to do? What are you going to do? Take it.
Take it. Take it. Take it. People power. Come. Just come. Never look at Kuba Negaguamu. Or there was Ogana Gakuba Maker. Talking about Kuba Gaguamu. Talking about Kuba Gaguamu. And now we turn Navajo. Talking about Gogana Tisa Tisa. Tewari Gogana Kutisa Tisa. What the name? Yes. People, you come. You come and we see what they are going to do. You are one person. One person can't defeat all of us. One person can't defeat all of us. Just know that. Yes. What are you going to do? Yes. Mujay, let's move. Let's move. Come this side. Don't know. Bano bafana bagezako tumanyira. We have to take away our fear.
Leta tetuli mbati olaba ndi kuogera nabo.
Bagende ko bagende.
Ndi president ali mukuogera. Ah, otame nawe.
Bano ibu prake nu.
Bano basaje. Bano basaje bagala kutumanyira. Abantu lwaki babasibira ebwe. Nefura ya baganyo zibawa. Nefura ya baganyo zibawa. Fura ya baganyo zibawa. Onule flyers. Onule flyers, come. If you want, come. Onule flyers. Bana basirikale bamanyira bumanyizi mwe kambaburi. Bana basirikale bamanyira. Yes. Bana basirikale bamanyira. David Lewis. Yes. Yes, we have to take away our fear. Tetugenda kubatya. Let us take our fear back. Yes. Mr. Lewis, we have to stand our ground. We have to stand our ground. Auntie, that is why we are mobilizing them to come in a big number. We don't have to fear them. Katibu waza pati chagula nyimbo stop inciting people. Bana basaja agenda kutuwa dembe e watali violence. Nga boba jana violence. Foku hita abantu okuja kulari. Echo chitegeza violence mudemu kumagezi. We have to take away our fear. To damn very bad off. So. Mwana bano bachati baagala kutumanyira mwe kambabuli.
And in a new Uganda, they will be proud to be police officers and soldiers. But I want those officers to know. I want the soldiers to know that they are not the first generation of soldiers whose future has been stolen. In 1979, Museveni was one of the leaders. In fact, he was the church, vice chairperson of the military commission.
Museveni now do better care than better at Bunkom Memon.
There was a generation of soldiers called the Ugandan National Liberation Front, UNLF. Many of those soldiers also belong to the former Uganda Army. They gave a lot of service to this country. Many of those soldiers are old and many of them have died. But they were not paid. Even when the government promised to pay those veterans, Museveni never paid them. I want you to know, those former soldiers in Uganda Army and UNLA,
onya John to twala UNLA mochiwa
but as soon as you go to a new Uganda you are going to get paid because you are entitled to that payment. Yam, that lost their animals. That lost loved ones and life. They lost lives and they lost loved ones. Many of those people have been claiming for very long what they lost during the NRA insurgents. For 35 years, Museveni has been promising them, but he has never paid them. I want you to know, brothers and sisters, that as soon as I become president of Uganda, you must be paid because you deserve it. I can go on and on and on, ladies and gentlemen. But like I've told you, my brothers and sisters, especially the young people over here, please spread this message no matter how hard it is.
Robert Kyagulanyi Ssentamu, President, May 2021.
Please. Let everybody here become a campaign manager. Because this is a revolution. I said this is a revolution. Now finally, even if I have so much to tell you, allow me to talk about only two last things. I will talk about the education. And in that education, I'll talk about the talent. When I was still at school, many of my friends, the Otims, the Labejas, the Lamex and all that, many of the intelligent boys and girls were coming from northern Uganda. Northern Uganda is talented with intelligent brains. But it is done on purpose to make sure they give you poor education. They make sure they sit on your talent. But in a new Uganda, everybody will be entitled to the same education. We will make sure everybody has a job. Because the education that we shall have in a new Uganda will not be creating job seekers but job creators. Our education will be styled in four styles. We shall focus on three areas. Number one, we shall make sure that the academics are perfect. This is not new. This is not new, I say. I am telling you, even if Museveni talks so much evil about the former president, Dr. Milton, to no bore.
Kano inge ani mono mu seven loga right to ali come you. Atinu oluoni obara me ono be president.
I want you to know that during the time of Dr. Milton Obote, Uganda had the best education.
Amin ninge oni wang la tu bore. Unuko me poyeti mala petuere.
And that is why when you move in northern Uganda, the people that are 50 years and above are more educated than the ones that are 50 years and below. We know that Museveni does not want anybody to talk about it. But I will talk about that because I don't fear him. And I want to tell you today, the people of Oyam, that Museveni fears you too. You can fear anything. I said you can fear anything. You can fear the rain. You can fear the birds in the sky. But please don't fear Museveni because he is the biggest coward. Now finally, I want to talk about the health care in the new Uganda. All of you know that every day more than 18 women die giving birth in Uganda. Those women are not relatives of Museveni. Those women are your sisters, your mothers, your daughters. Those women are you and me. And yet that money is there that can change our healthcare system.
Uganda ticketwere.
I want to promise you here today in Oyam. And I want you to remind me of that when I become president. I said it on this day when I was campaigning in Oyam. That every sub county will have a maternity center. Never again should the women of Uganda be scared to give birth to a new generation of Uganda. Did you know that every day more than 300 children die in Uganda? Every day, 300 children and more. Those are not children or grandchildren of Museveni. They are your children. When you move around northern Uganda, you will cry when you see how many children are suffering from Nodding disease. Nodding disease will have to go with Museveni. That this freedom is not too good to come very easy. I am promising you this, that we are going to achieve it together. I cannot do it alone. We will have to work together. I said we will have to work together. I know that all people since colonial days, they have used our own people to
Thank you.
Henry. I want that old grandmother of mine. Tell you what I want to be sure. Papa, I want you to be sure. Papa, that by the time you leave this world, you will be sure that you are leaving your children and your grandchildren in a Uganda, that will make them proud. I know you have seen that Uganda before. I know you feel the pain in your heart. I know you know that Museveni fought Obote, but he did 1 million times worse than Obote. In our culture, we respect elders. These are young people like me, they might not understand. But Papa, I know that you understand. And I know that the blessing of the elders are what will help us win. So I want on behalf of the elders in Oyam and Northern Uganda to promise you that these are not just words. These are promises that we must make sure that you see in your lifetime. And I know God will be with us because the people of Uganda are on our side. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you very much for listening.